Hey, welcome to Weekly Word. Thank you so much for watching this week, and I hope that you'll take opportunity maybe to share this with somebody that may need a word of encouragement, a neighbor, a coworker, somebody that God may place on your heart. And remember, at the end, we've got a great encouraging worship song that we hope will minister to your life as well. I want to talk to you today about opening our eyes and seeing what God wants us to see. There's a great story in 2 Kings chapter 6 about the prophet Elisha. There's a group of people called the Arameans that are coming against the children of Israel. But what happens is the king of the Arameans discovers that he thinks there's a traitor in their midst. In fact, he even asks his leaders, he goes, okay, which one of you is on the side of Israel? Because somebody knows what I'm about to do. And that's when one of the servants said, there is a prophet, a guy by the name of Elisha, that is there who tells the king of Israel everything that goes on and everything, you even say, king, in your own bedroom. Well, that scared the king. And he thought to himself, well, we've got to eliminate this guy. And so he sends an army after Elisha, one man, to kill him, to take him out, because he's the enemy. The Bible tells us one day Elisha's servant goes outside that little place that they were living, and he sees this massive army coming after him. He goes back inside and he says to the prophet Elisha, man, there is an army coming after us. And Elisha walks outside all calm, cool, and collected, because you see, Elisha knows something that the servant doesn't know. Elisha can see something that the servant can't see. And Elisha says to the servant, greater are those that are with us than are with them. And then Elisha says, God, would you open my servant's eyes that he can see what I see? And when the eyes of the servant is opened, he notices and sees chariots and horses of fire all around them. God is going to protect them and deliver them. You know, so often in life, we get so overwhelmed with the issues of life, the struggles of life, the things that we're dealing with every single day of our lives, that our eyes sometimes kind of get glazed over. And we just can't see what God is doing. Sometimes we can't see how God is protecting us and God is guiding us and God is making His presence known to us in so many different ways. Maybe today is a day to recognize and say, God, would you open my eyes so that I can see you, so that I can see your presence? Maybe when you spend time reading the scripture this week and praying and spending time with God, maybe in a devotion, you say, God, would you open my eyes and show me how you're with me to strengthen me and help me? You see, the same God that delivered the prophet Elisha and that servant on that day is the same God that can deliver you and deliver me. The same God that made His presence known in their life wants to make His presence known in your life and my life today. So no matter how overwhelming it may seem, stop and pray, Lord, would you open my eyes so that I can see? May God bless you and have a great rest of the week.
My chains are gone. I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy reigns. Unending love. Amazing grace, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. And I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. It was grace that taught my heart to fear. embrace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me, and like a flood, His mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. Oh, then when